Thanks for joining me, astrologer Patrick Arundel, for your in-depth weekly horoscope for week commencing the 30th of September. If you've yet to subscribe to my channel, I'd be honoured if you did so now. This week begins with that clustering of energy in the sign of Libra, very much to the fore. In fact, Venus and Jupiter continue to forge a gorgeous alliance in the first 2 days. And that points towards doing something playful, entertaining, or fun. But last week's new moon gave a boost to this Libran energy, but it also angled to Uranus. So over the next 4 weeks, it is going to be important to understand, whilst we're working at our relationships, which Libra governs, to just be conscious of how our values match up to the people we encounter. Now this week does see Mercury relocate into the deep and passionate sign of Scorpio, and also the modern ruler of Scorpio, Pluto. Well, that goes direct after a long retrograde which began on the 24th of April. Now of course, Pluto has been in a very business-like part of the situation in the sign of Capricorn. So I think if there has been any kind of delays or slowdowns around the enterprise that you're involved with, that can ease now. And this Mercury energy can also be very good for more entrepreneurial strands. But on Friday, Mars makes its way into Libra, where it will be for 6 weeks. This is a tremendous transit because it does in some ways diminute the more egocentric nature of Mars. Libra being about trying to find consensus, and Mars being very much about I, the self, well, it is actually technically in detriment in this location. But I think it gives us just a desire to get firmer boundaries, which can be a good thing, be a bit more competitive, which can be a good thing, but competitive in a way which seeks some kind of collaboration or cooperation with others. And that's where it's working through the energy of this Libra influence. But it is true to say that we have a quarter moon in Capricorn on Saturday, and that's going to be absolutely conjunct Saturn. And Saturn in Capricorn is quite a sobering kind of energy. So we may encounter someone from the end of this week and into next week who, however much we try to reach out to them and understand where they're coming from, they may be quite resistant to our charms. But equally, it's not going to be a good thing to try too hard to be a people pleaser. We just need to be naturally ourselves. Specific forecasts, Virgo, suggest that somebody close to you could be about to be enormously generous, particularly in the first couple of days of this week. Could be a family member even. When it comes to your own resources, however, it's going to be important to try to stifle any desire to splash out too loosely. There could be some sudden urges and impulses that come from last week's new moon and its link to Uranus. This week, Mercury, your ruler, does relocate into a much more upbeat and speedier part of your situation. This is going to switch on your mind. Also, Pluto ends a retrograde which began on the 24th of April. So if you have been waiting for a more creative side of your situation to really pick up momentum, that will help. But the arrival on Friday of Mars out of your sign and into Libra is lovely. If you have been working very hard over the last 6 weeks on an individual project, goal or aim, you can start to see tangible progress. It's also possible that you can do better financially over those next 6 weeks. But as the quarter moon emerges this weekend, it does link with Saturn. And I just feel that when it comes to your resources, someone close to you may look for some kind of assistance from you. And I think you could find this a bit oppressive, a bit disappointing. Perhaps they need reminding about your boundaries and also about the need to take greater personal responsibility for their own financial welfare. If you'd like to know what 2020 would hold for you individually, based on your time, date and place of birth, please see the link beneath this video. You can get the rest of this year free, plus 30% off. But for now, good luck and goodbye.